Hello, everybody. It's Merlin here, and I decided to give you my thoughts on something today. Hopefully, maybe a new format, we'll see. But one of my subscribers has been bugging me for some time to do some Trigun character analyses, and I don't really have the time right now to do it, but I kind of wanted to give him something in the meantime for anybody that's interested in Trigun. I thought I would do a kind of a brief retrospective on the series. My initial impressions of Trigun when I first saw it, I had this one friend of mine who was just kind of recommending that I watch Trigun. He's like, man, you know, you got to see the show. It's really good. And after, I don't know why I was so resistant to it, but for a long time, he just kept saying, you got to watch it, you got to watch it. And I finally did. And I remember that initially I didn't like it. It actually took me a while to get into, because if you're trying to watch Trigun, the first, like, I think 8 or 9 episodes, they're kind of one-off stories, very episodic, and they're often very comical and offbeat. And I'll be honest, it just wasn't... I know a lot of people like the Vash the Stampede goofy character, but I didn't really like him that much. I thought he was likable, but the humor and the style of the storytelling wasn't really my thing. But once you hit around like the first 10 episodes, it actually gets into the main story, which takes like this really dark turn, and it gets pretty serious for the most part. It's like, when I think of Trigun, I think of two, almost like two different shows. You've got the intro portion, which is almost filler, you know, which is just kind of there to kind of establish the characters. And then you have what Trigun really is. And I think for some people, Trigun's kind of both. And I believe the manga is a little bit different. But when I think of Trigun, I almost think of two different shows. Because if I was going to watch Trigun, I guess there are some things that are established in those earlier episodes that are worth seeing to get you familiar with the world. But once you get to the main story, you could just kind of skip there. Trigun is basically kind of the sci-fi western. We kind of learn early on that it's at some point far in the future, maybe like an old Earth colony, but nobody seems to know much about it. There's all these old spaceships that have crashed everywhere, and usually people have towns around them, but the technology is really uneven. It's kind of more like late 19th century technology, with the occasional steampunk and laser guns kind of everywhere once in a while. And, you know, everything's essentially based around the idea of bounty hunters and criminals and cowboys going after each other. And Vash is known as this criminal, and everywhere he goes, there seems to be disaster that follows him. And there are two ways you can kind of look at it when you're watching the show. They kind of play it up for laughs a lot of the time. Like it's not really that big of a deal. Like, oh man, because wherever he goes, trouble does seem to follow him. But ironically, throughout much of the show, it seems like trouble's following him because people are just going after him. And all these bad guys are shooting up the towns. But we do learn eventually that he actually has caused some great disasters that he actually does feel really bad about. And Vash is kind of this tragic character, and it's actually very similar to Kenshi Himura. A lot of people compare the two as being these kind of goofy characters that sort of use humor and their lightheartedness to kind of deflect from the darker aspects of their nature and their past. And Vash is one of those characters. He's also a character who is kind of the concept of the peaceful warrior, where also, a lot like Kenshin, these are two characters that are often compared probably because of their ideals and because they came out around the same time, and the English voice actor is the same guy. And, you know, Vash, one of the coolest things I've always felt about Vash is I know that there has been a lot of people that have given him criticism, like the main character, you know, he has to be kind of a badass, he has to not care, and I guess a lot of people might perceive Vash as being kind of whiny and overly sensitive, but Vash has a really big heart. And he's a person that really doesn't want to hurt people. He's not a violent person by nature. And I always thought that was kind of admirable. But the coolest thing about Vash is that he's a gunfighter. You know, his guns are legendary. And he is able to defeat pretty much all his opponents, especially in the early part of the series when he's fighting a lot of these other smaller antagonists. He's able to beat them in gun battles without killing them, which, if you think about it, means that he must be a really, really skilled gunman. Because to be able to use a gun and not really kill anybody is incredibly impressive. But, you know, Vash is this person who really, really values human life. And we learn early on, you know, once we get into the meat of the actual story, we learn about him actually being discovered by the colonists, or maybe an experiment. I think it's a little vague in the anime. And he's actually like this weird plant life alien that was merged with human DNA, and he and his brother, Knives, were raised by this woman, and everyone on the crew was kind of creeped out by them because they were strange, and I guess some people might have thought they could weaponize them, but it wasn't really ascertained whether or not that was really the truth. But with the exception of their mom, the woman that raised them, everyone was suspicious of them, and you know, they kind of had very different ideas of humanity based upon their early experiences. And Vash learned the value of the importance of life from his mother and really held true to that, whereas his brother kind of saw how easy it was to take life and saw the idea of power from there. And also, I think it's funny how they kind of had the same upbringing, but I'm guessing Vash was kind of almost focused on a little bit more. He was always a little bit happier, even as a child, and Knives just didn't really like the prejudice that humanity was feeling, and of course turned it around saying, you know, human beings have to be wiped out. So he and Vash have radically different ideas, and Knives, of course, is kind of hidden throughout most of the series, but we learn that's kind of the economy there. But Vash doesn't want to kill anybody, and that's kind of the main theme of the show, is the value of human life and when it is important or necessary or allowable to take life and when it isn't. But regardless, kind of stressing the idea that human life is important, while also kind of saying that humanity, even though we are higher life forms, or at least we perceive ourselves as such, we are just kind of part of the big natural cycle, you know, and some predator could kind of take us along, or some natural disaster. We're always kind of on the precipice or on the edge ourselves of just not being there anymore. And those are kind of the main themes I think are explored. There's also some heavy Christian symbolism as well. I believe the creator of the series had converted around the time, but I always kind of saw, you know, Vash's ideas as, I don't know if I necessarily say they were overly Christian. I think that most religions that value peace and goodwill could easily be placed around his philosophy, but there's a lot of imagery with the crosses and Wolfwood, who of course is a preacher. But other than that, I don't think there's anything really overt. The biggest comparison I always saw with Christian mythology and Christian teachings was the story of Cain and Abel. You know, I thought Vash and Knives kind of really balanced out those two concepts of the jealous brother going against the word of God versus the faithful servant of God, and how they're kind of entangled and how they just easily represent the two forces of good and evil. But, you know, Knives is actually one of my favorite villains, to be honest, and I'd like to talk about him more in depth too. Most people, when they talk about Trigon, though, if they talk about villains, I mean, well, when the Knives kind of creates this religion about himself, you know, that mankind is, you know, not worthy of living, basically, and he has a lot of followers that are really devoted to him and his cause, his nihilistic extermination plan or whatever it is. And of course, there's the Gung Ho Guns, who are all these really radically enhanced bounty hunter henchmen guys who all have these different techniques, and you know, they're all pretty cool, honestly. And Vash has to go off fighting them one by one. It gets kind of shonen at that point. But Legato Blue Summer is essentially their leader, and everyone always points out to that scene where Legato kind of forces Vash to take a life, forcing him to kill Legato, or else he's going to kill these other people because he has all these people under his control he can kill, and you know, he has all these things he can do, and he kind of finally is the person to put Vash in the corner. So I think a lot of people really gravitate more to Legato when they think about villains, and I can understand that. I remember a lot of people did top villains lists back in the day of classic anime, and Legato is always up there, but I think Legato is an interesting villain because he is kind of the really scary religious fanatic. But at the end of the day, he's just the number two guy. I mean, he's interesting, but the reason why I don't really think that Legato is as interesting as Knives is just because I thought Knives had more personality. He did. He just has a lot more range, and he has a lot more charisma. Legato's just kind of monotone, and I guess he's maybe scarier than Knives. Knives is a little more maniacal, and I guess he just seems like an evil version of Vash, but they're very different characters. And of course, you've got, you know, the insurance girls who kind of follow along, kind of narrating, and they're like, they kind of form a friendship with Vash, and they're kind of fun characters. I don't really like them as much as I think some people do. I mean, I don't think that they're necessarily bad characters. I think that they're probably fan favorites. I think they're good for comic relief, and you know, I think that they're the thing I liked about them is that they have a very specific job. I like the fact that they're trying to file these insurance claims because like Vash coming into a town, he is considered to be a moving natural disaster. He's as bad as an earthquake or tornado, to the point where people have to get insurance against him. And I think it's kind of interesting. They're trying to follow him and figure him out. And they're actually kind of fighters in their own. I guess they probably go into some pretty rough towns, so they have some good fights. There's a twist with Wolfwood, which I still to this day don't know how I feel about it. I won't actually talk about that one too much. I know I've tried to keep things mostly spoiler free. I mean, you know, but Wolfwood, there is something that happens with him because he kind of becomes, well, first of all, he's introduced pretty early on, and then there's kind of a break of time where he comes back, and I wasn't really sure, you know, how established their relationship was going to be. And then they become friends again, they become partners again, and then there's kind of a twist with him, and it's like this pretty big, kind of shocking thing, and then he's gone. You know, he's not in the series anymore, and I know a lot of people don't like the way it was handled. I think that the twist, actually, with him was interesting, and I liked the general presentation of that final episode was pretty intense. But I know a lot of people don't really like the way the character was handled because he went this radically different direction, and he didn't go out. I don't think he went out the most impressive way. I think that's probably one of the biggest mishandlings of the show, besides the fact that I think the pacing of the first like 10 episodes is just tonally totally different than the rest. But on the whole, I never liked Wolfwood as much as some people. Like, I think he's a cool character, but much like people's obsession with Legato, I like Vash more. I like his story more. Wolfwood's is kind of interesting. He offers a different perspective. I think he works well with Vash, but I feel like Wolfwood could have not been in the show, and it wouldn't have been a big deal. I wouldn't mind getting a spinoff about Wolfwood and his adventures, but I feel like it would be a very similar thing. I mean, obviously, you got the crosses that become all the different guns. I mean, it seems like it's inspired right from Desperado or one of those Robert Rodriguez movies. I'm pretty sure it is. El Mariachi and Desperado came out before Trigun, I believe. But it wouldn't surprise me. But on the whole, I really like Trigun. I think it's a classic anime. I think it's probably, if it's not, it's probably up in my top 20, top 25 somewhere. I actually never got all the way through the manga. I know it's a bit different, but I know Trigun Badlands is out there. It's one of those shows that some people say, would you want to redo it with newer animation? I think that the only thing I would do is maybe try to expand a little more on the henchmen by cutting down on the episodic stuff. Like, if you want to do some funny comedic stuff, just make some more specials or movies or something. But Trigun's a good show, and I guess I just ended up basically reviewing it here. I didn't go too in-depth with any of the characters, but sometime I'm actually planning on it, because Trigun's really been on my mind lately, and it's been a couple subscribers have been like saying, hey, you gotta do some character analysis. So I touched a little bit on some of those things today. And yeah, if you haven't seen Trigun for some reason, definitely check it out. I think it's like one of the great classic series from the 1990s. I think it's got a lot to offer for a lot of people. It's got action, adventure, it's got comedy. It's got a pretty good art style for the time. Some pretty interesting villains. There's actually some good characterization and some good themes that are explored. Some pretty heavy stuff, so it's definitely some things to leave you thinking as well as entertain you. But it's probably like an 8 out of 10 for me. I think it's a really good show. Just some minor pacing issues in the beginning, and maybe some mishandlings of things along the way, but overall, I think it's a really good show. It's still one of my favorites, and it's one that I definitely would like to go back to sometime. But yeah, this is going to be Merlin. I was talking about Trigun, and if you guys have any comments about it, let me know. Maybe some other things you'd like me to talk about. I'm probably just going to do some more informal vlog, retrospective review things, because it's just quicker, and you know, with my schedule, I could probably pump these out pretty easily, but I'm enjoying it, so I'd like to do more of these. But in the meantime, guys, until we talk about anime and stuff next time, stay magical. Peace.